Welcome back, RPA champions. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to reply with AI to all of your inbox inside of LinkedIn. Why not build an automation that is going to act as my own personal assistant? It is going to go visit LinkedIn from the LinkedIn chat page. So here we see it going to the LinkedIn page, clicking on the messages, going in the unread messages. And after that, what it's going to do, it's going to go through all of the unread messages that I have right here. It is going to take in the context of the conversation. It is going to take that context and pass it to ChatGPT. And then using some simple prompting, it is going to provide me this answer. If you are interested in learning automation, please subscribe to my channel because this is the kind of things that we see on my channel. And it is going to be an exciting journey. You are going to learn how to automate your processes, your manual and repetitive activities, and create amazing automations. Let's jump right into it. Just like all of the processes that we build, this is also an easy process. It is easy because it is made out of 20-something actions and is going to allow you to save countless hours of time, and you can adapt it for pretty much lots of different use cases. Let me go over this process. I want to remind you that I will leave a link to the code of this process so that you can copy and paste it into your own Microsoft Power Automate desktop and run it immediately. It will definitely need some fine tuning from you. That's why I suggest that you review the video together with me so that when you copy and paste this process inside of your Power Automate desktop, you can just spend a couple of minutes in fine tuning it and have it ready to serve you as well. So let's start first from these actions. We're going to leave the loop for later. So what we are doing is we're going to LinkedIn, to our LinkedIn feed. We have already logged in, so we don't need to do those actions. We're clicking on the messages, and then we're clicking on the unread messages. So if we go in our UI elements right here, we can see where we are clicking. We're clicking on the messages, which is in the menu, and then we're clicking on the unread. So that we're going to visualize all unread messages in view. After that, we're going to be clicking on, and here it's important that I show you what we are going to be doing exactly. So we have navigated to here, we have clicked unread. We're going to be clicking in each one of these one by one, and we are going to be getting the context of all of this chat, passing it to OpenAI, and then writing a summary right here. So to do that, we are first going to be clicking on this pane right here. Now to configure that, it is relatively, you just need to try it out a little bit and try different things. Now I have found that inside of the selector, there is a class that we can use that is called MS Conversation Card Content Selectable. This class never changes by adding the loop index to it, which since this is inside of a loop, we're going to be clicking on the first one, second one, third one, fourth one, fifth one, and so forth, until we reach 5, starting from 0. So one more time. So this selector that we have just created is a link to this div element. And this div element, as you can see right here, has a ordinal value. The ordinal value we are going to be replacing with a loop index. We're going to be removing any IDs or anything that might be weird and just leaving this class right here. This is going to make it stable and reliable, and make it work also every time we open this page again. After that, what are we going to do? We are going to extract the text. So we're going to be extracting this text from right here. Now this has a dynamic ID. However, it has a first part of the IDs always fixed. Therefore, we are going to go to this ID right here, and we're just going to remove the dynamic numbers that are going to be here, and change the operator to contains. This is going to make sure that once we click there, it is only going to look for this div with this ID with message list amber, and then who cares about the number. So these are the two complex parts of the selectors. Everything else is pretty much easy. After we have extracted all of the information that we need, we put this information inside of a variable. So right here, we put the information we extracted from the web page right here. Why? Because we need to remove the HTML tags, apostrophes, and so forth, so that we can send that message via API to OpenAI. What are we going to do next? We're going to replace those values. Right here in the post content, we're going to take that variable and remove all of the different strange characters that there might be that might mess up our response. Once we have done that, we are ready to prepare a prompt. This is a prompt that I'm using. So you will receive some HTML structured text, and your role is to make some sense out of this conversation between Gregor Maric and somebody else. You're Gregor Maric, and your job is to read the conversation. So now we post that stripped out, cleaned out version of the text that we have scraped from all of that context. Now, why are we doing that? We don't want to just get the last message. We want to get the entire conversation and the name of the person and their role and so forth. This entire conversation, we want to get it so that the AI can fine-tune the best response for us. This is optional, not necessary, depends on really how you structure your prompt. After that, we're also going to replace any apostrophes. And finally, we have our prompt ready. The next thing that you need to do is to invoke a web service. This is going to be the call that you're going to be making to OpenAI. These are the configuration parameters. This is how you have to set it. You can use my API key, but it is not going to be working. And then you have to give it a request body that looks something like this. Here we have the message, we have the role of the system and the content. So this is, again, I'm putting the assistant, the conversation into context with this prompt. And right here, role user, I'm giving it the stripped down prompt that I have prepared previously with all of the content I have scraped from the web page. After that, there is some other parameters that you can add, such as the model that you want to use, maximum number of tokens to output, the temperature, creativity, the number of stops, and so on. In the advanced options, make sure that you put the follow redirect to on, and you insert this configuration just like I have inserted it here. What we have to do next is we have to get the response from OpenAI, and we have to clean up this response. Now, I have tried doing this in different ways, and the best way that I have figured out how to do it is to set a variable, get the response from OpenAI, and let me show you what that looks like. So if we look at web service response, we have a response that looks like a JSON. We have to extract this right here from our response. We don't want all of this text. We just want that part of the text. So what we're going to do is we're going to write this to a JSON. We're going to write it to this JSON that I have stored on my document, on my computer. And after that, we are going to use a PowerShell script to extract the information from that JSON and put the value of the response into plain English and something that we can use inside of our send keys. Inside of our send keys, we just have the output of PowerShell, which we can see right here to be just the response that we need to prepare. And this is what we are going to be sending via keys to the message box and then clicking, waiting for wait and repeating this step. Repeating it, meaning going to loop index one, clicking on the new tab on LinkedIn right here and scraping the same information again and responding to the other message. This first loop is going to have this automation run for 5 times and then is just going to close the browser, go to unread because it's going to be new messages again, and reload the entire conversation. So let's try it one more time and see how it performs. Learning automation is becoming more and more important because you are going to become much more productive in your world. And right now, companies are looking to upskill their employees and promote, therefore reward employees that have these skills. Also, if you are working on a business and you are looking to grow your business and expand your business, it is important that you learn how to use these new tools that are going to allow you to save time, save money. And we can see that this automation is working. It is going from one conversation to the next conversation, getting the context and replying with a pretty good tone of voice that I will also reply. I hope that this also opens your ideas and opens your eyes to what are all of the potential of the automations that can be built. And using a tool such as Microsoft Power Automate Desktop and having knowledge also of OpenAI, ChatGPT, you can truly create some end-to-end complex automation that do things that previously were imaginable. giving you a competitive advantage and obviously allowing you to earn more money, to be more successful, to save time, play with your dog, and so forth. Ladies and gentlemen, it has been a pleasure showing you this. If you have been with me for so long, please make sure that you like this video, subscribe to the channel, and leave me a comment. Once again, thank you so much for watching this. Without you, this would not be possible. Thank you again and have a great day.